Hello everybody, Winifred Rowdy here, and welcome to a brand new LP. I'm sure you already know what it is, but welcome to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker. Alright, now, I have a bit of explaining to do. The first thing is, I decided that too many people have done this game already for my liking, so I thought, how am I gonna make this different? Well, what I planned on doing is doing the second playthrough of this game. Now, for those who don't know what the second playthrough is of Wind Waker, it's virtually the same game. It's pretty much the exact same thing as the first playthrough, except for the only difference is, basically, you saw the outfit Link was just in. He doesn't change into his green clothes in the second playthrough. There is only one real significant difference in the first playthrough and the second, but I'll explain that in a second. So basically how it works is when you play through the game and you beat the game for the first time, it'll ask you if you'd like to open up a file for another playthrough. So if you say yes, it'll make, normally your things are just green like this, but first of all, it'll make it look orange like so. And don't worry, it's virtually the same game. You don't need to go to some other Let's Play of this. It's pretty much the same thing. It's just I wanted to do a little switch up of this. So as you can see, my file name is Mommy, and that's so stupid. But when I did my first playthrough of the game, I thought it'd be funny if I named myself Mommy so that every time someone would say my name, they'd be calling me Mommy. I know that's dumb, but yeah, that's what I did. So let's get this started. So you don't have to see me naming my file. Oh, I can actually change the name. Should I keep it Mommy? Yeah, what the heck, man, I'll keep it Mommy. So here we go. This is but of one of the legends of which the people speak. Yeah, the thing about this game is it has a bit of a long intro, but it's not too bad. Long ago, there existed a kingdom where a golden power lay hidden. It was a prosperous land, blessed with green forests, tall mountains, and peace. Next! Next! But one day, a man of great evil found the golden power and took it for himself. Now, Zelda fans probably know what they're talking about here, but if you don't, I'll explain in a second. With its strength at his command, he spread darkness across the kingdom. Nice picture. But then, when all hope had died, and the hour of doom seemed at hand. Dot dot dot. A young boy, clothed in green, appeared as if from nowhere. Next. Wielding the blade of evil's bane, he sealed the dark one away and gave the land light. Next! It's going too slow, come on! Wasting time here, we're already at 3 minutes. This boy, who traveled through time to save the land, was known as the Hero of Time. There's a horsey there. Horsey. Hoisey. The boy's tale passed down through the generations until it became legend. Next. Come on. Yeah, this is a great way to start the LP. Then, a day came when a fell wind began to blow across the kingdom. Uh-oh. That's not good. The great evil that all through... that all thought had been forever sealed away by the hero, dot dot dot. Dot dot dot, once again crept forth from the depths of the earth, eager to resume its dark designs. The people believed that the Hero of Time would again come to save them. Dot. Next. But the hero did not appear. Well, doesn't that just suck? Faced by an onslaught of evil, the people could do nothing but appeal to the gods. Wonder what they mean by appeal. I'm not even gonna go there, man. In their last hour, as doom drew nigh, they left their future in the hands of fate. What became of that kingdom? Dot dot dot? Question mark? None remain, who know? Dot. Okay, now that that's sort- Oh, it's still going, holy crap! The memory of the kingdom vanished, But the legend survived on with a wind's breath. On the wind's breath. Dot. On a certain island, it became customary to garb boys in green when they came of age. Dot. Keep going. Clothed in the hero of green of fears, excuse me, they aspire to find heroic blades that cast down from evil. And cast down evil. The elders wished only for the youth to know courage like the hero of the legend. Dot dot dot. Alright, now that that long intro is, finished, we have yet another cutscene. But, don't worry, the game isn't always gonna be like this. So here we go, folks, Outset Island. Pretty much, I didn't explain this during the intro, but pretty much, oh yeah. Big Brother, here's another thing about the second playthrough. The girl there, Errol is her name, she has a different outfit at the beginning of the game as well. But it's just an outfit, it's not that different. And yeah, I'm just doing this to sort of change things up a bit. But basically the story that they're talking about for that whole intro was pretty much the entire game, Ocarina of Time. If you play the game, you definitely know what I'm talking about. So here we go, here's Link. And you see what he's wearing here, and for the second playthrough, you're pretty much, I'll explain a bit more of this later, but you're gonna wanna get used to it, let's just say. I knew you'd be in here. Hehehe. This is my favorite spot to gaze out at the sea. When I play with the gulls, I call it Arrow's Lookout. So, do you remember what day it is today? Man, I look stoned. Dot dot dot. You're still half asleep, aren't you? Looks like it. Did you forget? Forget what? No, I'm still looking stoned. Big Brother, it's your birthday! Oh, sick! It's my birthday! That's why Grandma had been waiting for you to come back to the house. Why is house in red letters? She's been waiting for a while now. Dot dot dot. It's a good thing I came to find you. I guess so. We should probably go home and see what Grandma wants, don't you think? Well, it's more like what I want. It's my present, don't you think? So here we go. We get our first controls of the game. Controls are pretty similar to just about any other 3D Zelda game. Ocarina of Time, Twilight Princess, Majora's Mask. You know, any stuff about that. The thing that sort of makes this game different is you can only swim for a finite amount of time. You'll see that in your bottom right screen. There is a meter. When it gets down, you drown. So just be cautious of that. It still gives you plenty of swimming time. But yeah, A is roll again. And if you talk to this kid here. Hoi, mommy. Yeah. See, that's why I named my file mommy. Hey, is it true that you have a little courage and run as fast as you can? Then you could jump to that rock out there? Huh. Is it? Tell me. Well, let's find out. So yeah, as most Zelda fans know, there's no real jump button to Zelda games. It's just you run at a gap and you'll automatically start jumping. So that's kind of cool. That always confused me the first time I played a Zelda game. Well, the first Zelda game I ever played was Ocarina of Time, and that always sort of confused me why you could never jump on your own. Oh yeah, one thing that sort of sets this game apart from other Zelda games is, can I get a good example of this? Not really. Okay, well in this game, if you want to pick something up, you press A, and if you want to just simply set it down, you press A. And no, it's R, but if you want to throw it, it's A. Normally for other Zelda games, it's just A while you're moving is throw it. But A while you're sitting down, it's not a huge difference. I'm not even gonna talk to this kid. Let's just get to Grandma's house already. Alright, go in the door. So here is Grandmother's house. And apparently Link lives with his grandma. Don't know what's up with his parents, but that's kind of weird. So here's Grandma. She's awfully sweet in this game, if I do say so myself. I've been waiting for you, Mommy. Who are you calling Mommy? You're my grandma. Here you are, Mommy. Try these on. These are special clothes, made of a special fabric that only the honest can see. Oh boy. Time certainly flies. I can't believe you're already old enough to wear these clothes. Yeah, here it is, man. You got the hero's new clothes. What the? Wow, they're really light. So yeah, this is the thing about the second quest. Man, look at my face. Yeah, but here's the thing about the second quest. You don't wear the green clothes, you wear what you're pretty much wearing now for the whole game, which is kind of cool. What's the matter? Why the long face? You can see them, can't you? Dot, dot, dot. Well, today is the day we commemorate the fact that you've reached the same age as the hero of the legends. You have to be proud about that for at least one day. Put them on and see if you can't fool anybody in town. In the olden days, this was the day boys were finally considered to be men. They were taught the ways of the sword to prepare them for battle with their enemies. But we don't live in such an age any longer, dot, dot, dot. Our ways are the ways of peace. Man, there's a lot of dot, dot, dots in this game. Nowadays, I suppose Orca is the only one on the island who still knows anything about swordplay. Hanging the family shield on the wall as decoration is another tradition that has been carried down from those days. Is it now? Yeah. Put those clothes on, Link. You can totally see them. Does this all make sense to you? Yeah. Except for the whole clothes part. I don't get why I can't see them. Is that nice, Mommy? They suit you perfectly. A perfect fit. Well, tonight I'm going to invite the whole town over for your birthday party, so I better start getting ready, shouldn't I? Your grandma's going to make your favorite soup for you tonight. Yeah, some good stuff right there, I'll tell you that much. I just know you're looking forward to it. Now, go get your sister, Errol. Okay. So yeah, that's pretty much the biggest difference in this game. For the whole game, you're running around in your pajamas. Normally, you just start up the game wearing these things, and then when you go talk to grandma, you permanently change into the hero's clothes, the green ones that you always see Lincoln. But that's not the case in the second playthrough, so that's kind of cool. Anyway. Hoi, Mommy. Press L right there and use A to talk to me. Try it. Sure. That's correct. You're a smart one. You, my friend, have just L-targeted me. You see, when you press L, you can target certain objects. I, for one, use it quite often to talk to folks who are far away from me. Of course, even if there isn't anything to target, you can just press L to face forward, you know. It's quite handy indeed. Oh man, I know all this crap already, holy... Oh. Yeah, basically there's two ways to control the camera in this game. Number one is just pretty standard for Zelda games. Just press L while you're facing somewhere and you'll get the camera behind you, so that's really useful. But also, the camera's a lot like the camera in Super Mario Sunshine, too. You can use the C-stick to sort of bring it around. Pretty much exactly how you do it in Super Mario Sunshine. Anyway, so Grandma told us to go get... Errol. And you'll probably see me rolling a lot because, as many Zelda fans know, rolling is faster than just walking, so you'll probably see me doing it. And on top of that, it's just kind of addicting to do. But we'll make our way up the weird rib cage looking ladder. And we're coming up on 15 minutes here. I'm gonna have to end the video off soon. I don't know. There's a cutscene coming up. Can I fit it in? I sure hope so. So hey, Errol. Yeah, her outfit is different as well. Ah, hoi, big brother. Did your grandma make that outfit for you? You always wear the same outfit. I think you need a new look. Am I the only one who can't see these things? Seriously? I think they're pretty neat, though. So anyway, Mommy, dot, dot, dot. Can you close your eyes and hold out your hand? Just for a second? Aw, are you going to put something nasty in there? I'm going to give you my most treasured belonging, dot, dot, dot. But just for one day. Happy birthday! Link, did you close your eyes, dude? So you got the telescope. This is pretty much... Well, it's the first time we end the game. And it's widely believed that it's not all that useful. But I can think of something that you use to do it quite a bit later on in the game. You don't need it. You only really need it once in the entire game. But, Okay, so you just assign it to... Okay, I'll get into this in a later video. You just assign it to either Y, X, or Z. Anyway, I talked to... You know what? I might as well show it up. You know what? I'm going to end the video off right here. So, next time on Let's Play Wind Waker, which will be part 2, we'll be doing more stuff. And we'll still be in our little lobster pajamas. So, see you then. Have a nice day.